Congregation, please stand. Jesus said, "I am the resurrection and I am the life. He who believes in me, though he die, yet shall he live. And whoever lives and believes in me shall never die."
The steadfast love of the Lord never ceases. His compassion never fails. Every morning they are renewed.
Jesus said, "Let not your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me."
I am sure that neither death nor life, nor angels, nor principalities, nor powers, nor things present, nor things to come, nor height, nor depth, nor anything else in all creation will be able to separate us from the love of God in Christ Jesus our Lord.
For if we live, we live to the Lord, and if we die, we die to the Lord. So then, whether we live or whether we die, we are the Lord's. For to this end Christ died and lived again, that he might be Lord both of the dead and of the living.
We brought nothing into the world, and we take nothing out. The Lord gives, and the Lord takes away. Blessed be the name of the Lord.
The eternal God is our refuge, and underneath are the everlasting arms. With faith in Jesus Christ, we receive the mortal remains of our sister Shahini Elizabeth for burial. Our sister was washed in holy baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Let us therefore with confidence pray to God our Heavenly Father, the giver of life, that he will raise her to perfection in the company of the saints. The Lord be with you.
And also with you.
Let us pray. O God of grace and glory, we remember before you this day our sister Shahini Elizabeth. We thank you for giving her to us, her family and friends to know and love as a companion on our earthly pilgrimage. In your boundless compassion, console us who mourn. Give us faith to see in death the gate of eternal life, so that in quiet confidence we may continue our course on earth, until by your call we are reunited with those who have gone before, through Jesus Christ, our Lord. Amen.
Thank you.
We pray that having opened to her the gates of love and life, you will receive her more and more into your joyful service, that with all who have served you in the past, she may share in the eternal victory of Jesus Christ, our Lord, who lives and reigns with you, the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Then the saying that is written will be fulfilled. Death has been swallowed up in victory. Where, O death, is your victory? Where, O death, is your sting? The sting of death is sin, and the power of sin is the law. But thanks be to God, who gives us the victory through our Lord Jesus Christ. Therefore, my beloved, be steadfast, immovable, always excelling in the work of the Lord, because you know that in the Lord your labor is not in vain. The word of the Lord.
Or in prison
and visited you.
And then the king will answer them, truly I tell you, just as you did it to one of the least of these my children, you did it to me. Then he will say to those on his left hand, you that are cursed, depart from me into the eternal fire prepared for the devil and his angels. For I was hungry and you gave me no food. I was thirsty and you gave me nothing to drink. I was a stranger and you did not welcome me. Naked and you did not give me clothing. Sick and in prison and you did not visit me. Then they will also answer and say to him, Lord, when was it that we saw you hungry or thirsty or a stranger or naked or sick or in prison and did not take care of you? Then the Lord will answer them, saying, truly I tell you, just as you did not do it to one of the least of these, you did not do it to me. And these, then he will answer all of them, saying, truly I tell you, you have received your reward. And these he will send away into eternal punishment, but the righteous into eternal life. The Gospel of Christ.
Each time I think of your family, a hymn comes to mind. And I want to sing two verses of that hymn for you today. And hope that when you have time, you will meditate on them and receive the comfort and solace that are yours in Jesus Christ. Let us pray. Lord, thy word abideth, and our footsteps guideth. Who its truth believeth? Light and joy receiveth. Grant then, Lord, that the words of my lips and the meditations of our hearts will be acceptable in your sight, you who are our rock and our redeemer. Amen. My brothers and sisters, from all accounts, let's not forget that name. Was in very essence a woman of the people, lauded by many on both sides of the political divide for her dedication to duty, the compassion and care she infused into every assignment, ensuring beyond abstract policies and projects the well-being and welfare of the ones whose livelihood they would most likely impact. She epitomized a way of being that could be considered atypical of the prevailing political culture, but not so of her Christian upbringing and beliefs. What she would have learned from the Judeo-Christian tradition, and more specifically the life and teachings of Jesus, that would have informed and given meaning to her and our value systems, is that a life that truly honors God, regardless of its sphere of reference, be it ecclesial, political, or any other arena for that matter, such a life finds fulfillment in praxis that issues from a theology of humankind created in the image of God. The one so minded then learns to appreciate the unquestioned reality that being thus made, every person, whatever the circumstances of their birth, the hue of their skin, their presumed socioeconomic status or political affiliation, every human being has something of the divine nature within their DNA and has been earmarked for salvation, or the making whole, the reuniting of divinity with humanity, which Jesus Christ embodied, and for which he died and rose and ascended to the Father. Within each human being, therefore, within each one of us, resides the potential for goodness, for actualizing and making real and relevant the redemption that is at the heart of God's plan of salvation. So once again, brothers and sisters, no individual, regardless of family heritage, how they speak, or whether they live in country or town, no person is perceived as inferior to another in the sight of God. Within the all-pervading nature of Jesus' words in Matthew 25, which we heard read earlier, and alluded to in the preceding chapter 24, as well as in the Beatitudes of chapter 5, and other places throughout Scripture, is embedded something akin to a manifesto for all times and seasons. There is no statute of limitations with respect to its application. From generation to generation, therefore, to every man, woman, and nation, is issued a charge, the stewardship of which all, with deference to no one, will be required to give an account. Compare that understanding, brothers and sisters, with what we continue to experience in our world, in this nation, resulting from our many and varied divisions, created ostensibly for generating order, creating efficiency, and some would even say a life more abundant. As Jamaicans, we live within the limiting effects and barriers of our own unique socio-political, what the Americans call gerrymandering, that are not only difficult to circumvent, they are kept in place by systems, the effects of which is nothing short of oppressive. We have gathered today in the context of a Christian service of thanksgiving for the life of one we may very well say has gone too soon. One whose life within and outside the limelight was dedicated to the upliftment of all God's people. The context of our gathering is also, and perhaps more so, one in which we celebrate and give thanks to Almighty God, in whose image we were made, who offers each one of us and all people the free gift of salvation, who will one day demand from everyone an accounting for our stewardship, and given the unprecedented nature of all we have been experiencing in real time, it may be that such a day has already begun. In the gospel reading, Matthew paints what may seem like a cryptic picture, but even so, he employs imagery that his hearers then as now would have little difficulty assimilating. Retelling this particular parable as a culminating piece within a sequence of parables and sayings of Jesus, addressing the matter of preparedness for the final accounting, Matthew offers a life lesson that may be summarized in this way. When your life is lived and service is given from a heart that seeks the welfare, not of self, but another. You have begun to activate the divine image within you. When you can perceive beyond the unfortunate nature of their circumstances, the God-bequeathed dignity of those to whom life has been less than kind, and know them to be your brother, your sister, you have begun to see as Jesus sees. When you are prepared to be persecuted for the sake of righteousness, with godly integrity as your companion, you have begun to understand the call of true leadership. There remain too many of us, brothers and sisters, who believe that a position of leadership nullifies certain values and related behaviors. So enraptured do we become with our own misplaced sense of importance. It becomes extremely difficult, even impossible, to hear the voice of God. And hence, by our clearly devised machinations, we keep the presumed ignorant in their places, places of dependence, on the assumption that they will always look to and believe that it is from us that their salvation comes. But the Word of God says otherwise. And there is a sense in which Matthew's placement of this particular parable highlights in effect and cautions all of us, but particularly those who assume the mantle of leadership, that in the course of the accounting, we will be required to give the law of divine reversal will be applied. Brothers and sisters, in these what I have termed differently difficult times of social distancing with related sense of loss and longing that many are experiencing, not only of the physical presence of loved ones, but of those intangibles we often take for granted. The compassion, care, the kind word or smile that fills the soul with joy beyond description. I am reminded of words by the poet John Donne, who said, "No man is an island. Every man is a part of the main. Any man's death diminishes me because I am involved in mankind." Our beloved Shaheen's passion was serving humanity made in God's image by representing the people of her constituency, whoever and wherever they were. Hers were values influenced by the teachings of Jesus, values that were a significant feature of the culture within her home, church, and school. Values that sadly decide, decided are no longer relevant. But here's something worth considering. In recounting the parable we heard today, Matthew opened up for his audience an opportunity to set things right. Within the providence of the God we serve, our presence here today affords us the same opportunity. And so, as a fitting tribute to the one whom we loved in life and in death, but even greater, as a fitting tribute to the one without whom we cannot live, the one without whom we dare not die, the Word of God enjoins us through the Spirit of Jesus Christ. If you have ears, then listen. And in listening, hear and obey. For in so being, you will inherit the kingdom prepared for you from the foundation of the world. So, my brothers and sisters, the choice is as much mine as it is yours. I pray that we will choose wisely. The last verse of the hymn I started with goes like this.
It's done. Let us with confidence and hope confess the faith into which we were baptized as we say, I believe in God, Father Almighty, Creator of heaven and earth. I believe in Jesus Christ, His only Son, Lord. He was conceived by the power of the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered on the Mount of Pilate, was crucified and died and was buried. He descended to the dead. On the third day he rose again. He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of God.
kingdom come again and judge the living and the dead. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life of the last day.
For our sister Shahini Elizabeth, let us pray to the Lord Christ, who said, I am the resurrection, and I am life. Lord, you consoled Martha and Mary in their distress. Draw near to us who mourn for Shahini Elizabeth, and dry the tears of those who weep.
Hear us, Lord.
You wept at the grave of Lazarus, your friend. Comfort us in our sorrow.
Hear us, Lord.
You raised the dead to life. Raise our sister Shahini Elizabeth to eternal life.
Hear us, Lord.
You promised paradise to the thief who repented. Bring our sister Shahini Elizabeth to the joys of heaven.
Hear us, Lord.
Our sister was washed in baptism and anointed with the Holy Spirit. Give her fellowship with all your saints.
Hear us, Lord.
She was nourished with your body and blood. Grant her a place at the table in your heavenly kingdom.
Hear us, Lord.
Comfort us in our sorrows at the death of our sister. Let our faith be our consolation and eternal life our hope.
Father God, we pray to you for Shahini Elizabeth and for all those who we love but see no longer. Grant her eternal rest, that light perpetually shine upon them, and may she and all the faithful departed in the mercy of God rest in peace.
Amen.
During the singing of the hymn, every praise and offering will be received for St. Matthew's Church, Claremont. Individuals will be coming around with the collection bag. There will be no need for the bag to be passed from person to person. They will come before you, and if you have an offer, just place it in the bag. The offertory here.
Every word of worship, we're gonna fall. Father, we offer you these gifts which you have given us, this bread, this wine, this money, that we offer ourselves, our lives, and our work, to become through your Holy Spirit a reasonably holy and worthy sacrifice. As this bread and wine become the body and blood of Christ, so may we and all your people become channels of your love, through the sake of Christ our Lord.
intercession, his continual intercession for us in heaven, and looking for his coming again in glory, we offer you thanksgiving this holy and life-giving sacrifice. Look with favor on your church's offering, and grant that we who eat and drink these holy gifts may be filled with your Holy Spirit and become one body in Christ, and serve you in unity, constancy, and peace. May you make us a perpetual offering to you, and enable us in communion with Blessed Mary and the whole company of heaven to share in the inheritance of your saints. Remember, Shahida Elizabeth, in baptism she died with Christ. May she also share his resurrection, when Christ will raise our mortal bodies and make them like his own in glory. Welcome into your kingdom our departed brothers and sisters, and all who have left this world in your friendship. There we hope to share in your glory, when every tear will be wiped away. On that day we shall see you, our God, as you are. We shall become like you, and praise you forever, through Christ our Lord, from whom all good things do come. With him and in him and through him, by the power of the Holy Spirit, we worship you, Father Almighty, with all who stand before you in earth and heaven, in songs of everlasting praise.
Be glory and power, be your
Almighty God, we thank you that in your great love, you fed us with the spiritual food and drink of the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ, and have given us the foretaste of your heavenly banquet. Grant that this sacrament may be to us a comfort in affliction, and the pledge of our inheritance in the kingdom, where there is no death, neither sorrow nor crime, but the fullness of joy with all your saints, through Jesus Christ our Savior.
Amen. Please stand for the final communion.
Give rest, O Christ, to your servant, Shahid Elizabeth, with your saints,
where sorrow and pain are no more, neither sighing nor crying everlasting.
You and I are mortal, the creator and maker of humankind, and we are mortal, formed of the earth, and the earth shall be returned. For so did you ordain when you created me, saying, you are dust, and to dust you shall return. All of us go down to the dust, yet even at the grave we make our song, Alleluia, Alleluia, Alleluia.
Give rest, O Christ, to your servant, Shahid Elizabeth, with your saints, where sorrow and pain are no more, neither sighing, but to life everlasting.
Let us commend our sister Shahid Elizabeth to the mercy of God, our Maker and Redeemer. Deliver your servant Shahid Elizabeth, Sovereign Lord Christ, from all evil, and set her free from every bond, that she may rest with all your saints in the eternal habitations, where with the Father and the Holy Spirit you live and reign one God, forever and ever.
Thank you.
beseech you, a sheep of your own fold, a lamb of your own flock, a sinner of your own redeeming. Receive her into the arms of your mercy, into the blessed rest of everlasting peace, and into the glorious company of the saints in light.
Amen.
O God of peace, who brought again from the dead our Lord Jesus Christ, the great shepherd of the sheep, through the blood of the eternal covenant, made you perfect in every good work to do his will, working in you that which is well-pleasing in his sight. The blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, be among you and remain with you this day and forevermore.
Amen.
Alleluia, Christ is risen.
The Lord is risen indeed. Alleluia.
Let us go forth in the name of Christ.
Thanks be to God.